begun streaming. I thought I pushed the button already, but I did not because I am a idiot. Okay, yes, the streaming is starting. Sweet. So, yay, I am seeing it. So, I gave myself a day off. Whether or not I actually have a day off is another question. Blah, 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 blah. I felt like doing a day off, so I am doing a day off, and I figured let's draw. And I'm not all that amazing at digital art, as you will see very quickly. But, I thought it'd be fun to hang out with people online if anyone wanted to hang online with me while I do some casual drawing stuff. And yeah, a few days ago on Tumblr, I think it was something like 5 days ago, I don't know, is we were talking about things that I could hypothetically draw, and someone suggested that I draw Rufus from Deponia. Oops, wrong layer. But in Hiccup's clothing from How to Train Your Dragon. So that's what this is. He looks slightly hiccupy because I gave him Hiccup's floofy hair. But hopefully, with that large floof up at the top, it will look like Rufus. And I'm thinking that with some coloring choices, he will eventually look more like Rufus in the end. I guess we'll see. Yeah, so that's what I'm doing. I started by drawing Rufus by hand because I am not very confident in digital art yet. I'm behind the entire flippin' world. And so I prefer to do things by hand. I start up by hand, and then I transfer the hand sketch to digital and try to clean up my proportions and yada 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 there. I drew Rufus more according to the proportions that Deponia has, where he's a 4 heads tall, which gives him a giant ass fucking head. Yeah, I don't know if it's working or not. It's probably not. But, I can look at it later and see if I really hate it once I get the lining a little bit cleaner. But at the moment, I'm just going with it because why not? Okay. Yeah, that's better. Give him that stupid ultra skinny neck that Deponia has. Not quite as long, though. Deponia gives characters really long necks in their art style. And while it's cute, I'm not gonna go with that. Go. Yay. Go. I might end up pulling on some music. Hopefully, music that is non-objectionable to anybody. Probably classical, honestly. I feel classically oriented at this point in time. So, I might just pull up some Mozart, and you can complain if you so desire, but I have controls of the music, so yeah. Yay, Mozart. Oh, hey, hello, Fury, how you doing? And hello, Jaya, as well. It's good to see y'alls. There we go. Jaya, was it you who suggested me draw Rufus in Hiccup's hair? Because this is what we're working on now. I might actually. Okay, so we're saving, and then we're gonna do something drastic. Because I'm not happy with that hair. And hair is my favorite thing, so if I'm not happy with the hair, then that is terrible. So we're gonna actually erase the hair and completely redo it, despite the fact that I sketched it. So, yeah, cool. We're doing the Rufus as Hiccup, specifically. But it will look more Rufusy once I actually get the color palette, I hope. The two look so frickin' similar, so yeah, that's the fun thing. So I've tried to make it clear through, like, the nose structure and stuff. And once I get, like, the hair, beard stuff there, yeah. So Jaya says better than Mario Squad. Oh no, Furious says better than Mario Squad. So what's better than Mario Squad? The design, the music, the what? Okay, so we're gonna try to redo the hair completely by just there. Make it a little bit more Rufus-y, honestly. So, yeah. Meh. Oh, Mario Squid. What? I am so confused right now, Fury. Okay, you had me draw that. Okay. Alright, so talking about having to draw. Okay. There. And like always, everybody has long hair syndrome, as I jokingly call that. Is every single time that I draw a character, their hair magically grows. Oh, how is the audio speech balance? Because I am listening to music. Just want to make sure that the music isn't drowning out my voice or shit. Okay, so there we go, and then we'll give him some facial hair. And I actually give Rufus a lot more facial hair than he has in game because I like him all. Stuff. Music's a wee loud? Okay, let's see what the button is. Sorry, you're gonna be seeing some weird stuff. Settings, audio, advanced. No. Okay, let's see what I can do. Oh, I know what I can do. We're gonna do it this way. Hopefully the volume mixer actually does the trick. And then I can also... sound setting. Nope, wrong one. Darn it. My microphone, levels, microphone boost, and will give me more of a microphone boost. See if that does the trick. Make it more balanced. Okay. So, Furious, does it take a wild guess as to what I'm doing while lurking? Are you drawing dragons? Because you never draw dragons, so that would be just really weird if you were drawing dragons while we were doing this. I'd be so surprised that I'd, like, fall out of my chair and start screaming and pulling out my hair and crying at the absurdity of that concept. Okay. Cool. Oh, you're doing Minecraft! Yes, that sounds like you, doesn't it? Alright, well, you enjoy that Minecraft, you nerd. Wolfie, how's it going? How's it going? Oops, that was stupid. Okay. As you can see, I am not the world's greatest artist, but I figured it'd be, you know, why not stream, hang out with people, and so forth, because I love hanging out with you guys, and it's a lot more fun than drawing alone in my room in the dark or something. Curious, well, yeah, will you enjoy the music and drawing, you nerd? Alright, so Wolfie, you've been doing more Celeste. Your fingers hurt. Gosh. And yay for writing as well. So, I remember you making some comment. You're getting close to finishing that game, aren't you, right? Am I wrong? Did I remember that right? I do eventually need to buy that game. That does look like an interesting one. And you and everybody else I know who plays it speaks only positive things of the game, which is cool. Okay. Oh, bloody hell, I put it on the wrong layer, of course. At least I caught that early, right?
Nope.
Digital art. You always have to draw on the wrong layer at least once and hate your life. Okay, Wolfie, I finished the game, including all the bonus levels, but I'm redoing some levels. Oh, okay. Smithy. And there's a new level coming. Oh, I didn't realize that they released new levels after the main release. Well, that's sort of cool. I respect that. Alright. Very mood for the wrong layers. Dude, yeah, I hate it so bad, but that's how it frickin' goes, isn't it? Stupid layers. Like, layers are the blessing and the curse of the digital art world. They really are. Alright, so Fury, what you're doing on Minecraft, you're just casually doubling my super smelter-like resources, aren't even a big deal. Spiffy, spiffy. Okay, the main story is 7 chapters, and there's a bonus chapter 8 now, and they're about to release chapter 9. Well, that's really cool! I can appreciate them continuing to add on like that. So is it just, like, the extra levels are sort of side quests, side stories, sort of extra information, or are they completely just fillery or stuff? Fury, I'm laughing hard at your Emperor's New Groove analogy. I feel that so bad, and it's so true, and I hate it. Yum. There we go. Hiccup in his stupid clothing. Actually, I love Hiccup's clothing for being as ridiculously, complex as it is, it makes it fun to draw. It's so ridiculous, and Hiccup, you're such a weirdo. But it is fun to draw. Oh, okay, so it's more about challenge than story. Okay, okay. That makes sense. And we're doing the paranoid save often trick. Alright, I need to extend the canvas. And I'm really working on low resolution, but I don't care. This is just a quick scribble, so whatever. Yeah, that's what I thought. Yikes. There we go. Meh. Thanks, Wolfie. Yeah, and I know everyone's gonna mistake this person for Hiccup, so I might just turn it into Hiccup. Technically, it's not supposed to be Hiccup, but it is Rufus in Hiccup's clothing. I love drawing hair with floof, and I'm glad you like it. I'm slightly grumpy about, like, 300 aspects, but I think that's sort of what happens when you draw anything. It's like, nope, that's not what I intended. I love drawing floof. Floof, like, hair is my weakness. When I draw anything, hair is my weakness. I love hair so much! Like, hair is unfairly fun. Yep, yep, that's why there's more stubble. I'm gonna be taking the color palette directly from the Deponia art reference book. They actually tell you what every single color is. So that might help a little bit, but I'm guessing that he's gonna be mistaken for Hiccup the whole time, because I'm not as clear as I could be. Also, not many people know the characters, so. But either way, fun to draw, fun to practice. Eh. There's that stupid flippin' buckle that I'm. Eh. Okay, edit, redo. The sad thing is, when I draw Hiccup, his hair gets even floofier than this. Hiccup's hair just becomes this whoosh! Yep. Yeah, the braids is intentional because Jaya wants, well, I think, yeah, because I think Jaya was the one who suggested Rufus in Hiccup's clothes. I like drawing the braids, but I might end up taking those out because I might just go more close to his actual hairstyle. We'll see. There's a lot that has Gold been braiding him. Oh my gosh, that would be hilarious. I can't imagine him staying still long enough for her to get that accomplished, let alone accomplished successfully. Like, you know, sure, maybe he'd be like, yay, Goal's paying attention to me, but this is also Rufus, who, you know, is Rufus-y, so he's not gonna really have much positive things to say about something like braids. Okay, that is completely half-assed right there, but no one's gonna notice. Shh, you guys don't know either. Honestly, yeah, let's see what it looks like without the braids. We're doing a quick save, because it is a little... The braids have actually been bothering me for a while, so... As much as I love drawing braids, I might end up putting his hair much closer to the actual Rufus hair. And do it that way. And I hate making hair shorter. I don't want to make his hair shorter. But we can do less fluffy, more... Nope. Sorry, the hair has to look fluffy. I don't like it otherwise. Okay, that looks a little bit clearer. And then we'll really emphasize this stupid fucking floof up here. There. That helps a little bit. And the big heavy nose right here helps. Oops, I don't want to double line that. Rufus does have pretty short in the back. It is the yeah, whenever I draw Rufus, it turns into much longer hair in the back. I have... Yeah. It is pretty short in the back, but opposite of a mullet. Really is. What's interesting though is like if you really consider the front versus the back, technically the front is about the same length as the back. You just usually don't grow your front out that much. That hair must, and I cannot stress this enough, must disobey the laws or of physics and anatomy. Fish. I mean, his hair, he's throwing his head back. That's why the floof goes up. But, I mean, honestly, like, Rufus's hair, when I was making that stupid fucking wig for my cosplay, and trying to get it to do that floof that he has, his hair disobeys the laws of physics. His hair is so stupid. And I know they say in Deponia that he uses, like, oil and stuff to grease his hair up like that, which is so gross. Yeah, that hair is not how normal human hair acts at all. Ew, yeah, Wolfie, imagine how greasy the hair must be for that front part staying up. I think about it, and then I hate thinking about it, because I'm like, oh, it would be so greasy, let's be real. Like, the animation makes it look cute and fluffy, but it is not gonna be cute and fluffy in the real life. It's gonna look like this greasy disaster, and no wonder people mistake him for a hobo. Like, ugh, it's gotta be awful. It's really gotta be awful. I cannot imagine it not being awful. There. But then, you know, Deponians probably have a very different sense of what looks good anyway. There we go. Okay, I messed up right there. That needs to be less curved. Does that look better? Yes, that's better. Sweet. Aw, you gotta eat soon? I mean, to be fair, Fury, food is a good thing, and it is getting close to dinner time. I actually haven't eaten today, unless you count, like, a few M&Ms. That doesn't really count, does it? Oh well, hush. Quiet. I'll get food eventually. Okay. And there we go. Save yet again, doing the paranoia save function. Alright, which movement was this? Because I love this movement and it's so famous. Okay, it's 39, the finale. Okay, that's a famous one. Okay, cool. Oh, is my... Symphony 38 from Mozart's Next Suite. I love that song way too flippin' much. Sweet. Alright. Ugh. I hate shoulders. Oh, and I'm on the wrong layer. Look at that. I am on the wrong layer. Ugh. Okay. Again. I know my drawing process will speed up drastically once I actually start drawing the initial drawing on the tablet itself, but ugh. I am not a fan of that. Very greasy hair shudder. Yeah, no kidding. Oh man, it's so gross, but you know? That's what he'd be. Like, everything about Rufus is just so freaking gross. Like, you know, his jacket looks neat and okay in the animation itself, but every single time he talks about his clothing or people talk about his clothing, we know that his jacket is filled with stains and everything. Ew, should Inferno would react to that hair. There would be... Rufus would be a candle. He would be an immediate candle is what would happen. Dr. Pickle says, here to watch you art while I make dinner. Yay! Cool! Enjoy the dinner, and thanks for joining! By the way, I probably pronounce people's names wrong as I'm reading them. Is it Dr. Pickle? Dr. Pickle? Wow. Dr. Pickle, or is it Dr. Pickle, or just, you know, want to check to make sure I'm not saying your name, like, completely wrong? Please correct me, all of you guys, if I say something that is not how you envision the sound of your own... user, IRL, I cannot talk today. You know what I'm talking about. Your username. Rufus has way too much random shit in all his clothes. All those fish. Everything about Rufus is a disaster, and that's what makes him amazing. But yikes. Alright, it is Dr. Pickle or just Pickle. Perfect! Awesome! That is a wonderful name. BT dubs. Nope, that thumb is too short. Okay, we'll curve the thumb to fudge it. Yeah, that's really fudged and that's really crappy, but who cares? I probably shouldn't be pointing out all the flaws of my drawing while I am drawing. But, oh well. Finger! Technically, there should be a third one right there. And then the pinky, we'll just have the pinky sort of hiding in the back. Oops. And again, wrong layer. I am a mastermind at this. Dr. People works too. I am a people as far as I'm aware. Very wonderful. That's good to know that you're not like a Tyrannosaurus Rex stalking humanity from the shadows, waiting for the Space T-Rex uprising that'll inevitably come in the next century. Alright, I'm pulling up Inferno, How to Train Your Dragon on my other monitor, which you guys don't see, just to, double-check how I'm drawing it. I'm gonna be oversimplifying the design, but still want at least some correctness to what I'm drawing. Alright, so there's, yeah, that hook at the bottom. And then, oops, have to do that. Hiccup, why are you such a diva with all of your designs? There. How's that for... Close enough. Good, good. Design simplified enough for my liking. Cool. And then I actually have to extend the canvas a bit more. And man, I did get that hair close to the fire! Yikes! Okay, image, resize canvas. Okay. Cool. We did it. You could be a linguistically apt T-Rex. The beauty of online anonymity. Whoa, did I actually say, is it anonymity or it's anonymity, isn't it? Darn it, I was gonna be so proud and toting the fact that I pronounced it correctly. I did not. Alright, so Wolfie's saying, I feel like Hiccup isn't a disaster like Rufus, but he's still kind of lingering teenage boy hygiene standards. That's an interesting comment. Like, thinking about Hiccup's hygiene, I never really thought about that. Oh, Fury, I don't want to think about Hiccup's clothes that much. Like, you know, when you think about it, Hiccup does wear the same thing every single day. I know that's animation, you know, how animation design works, but at the same time, you know, it would not be beyond me to think that even if they weren't limited by those design constraints, Hiccup would wear the same frickin' thing every single day. He is a diva when it comes to his outfits, but at the same time, I don't imagine him having a lot of them. Of course, you can still be clean even with those, but whatever. Hiccup's not gonna be as much of a disaster as Rufus is, that's for sure. But that is not a hard bar to pass. Technically, there's 3 hooks. I might drop it down to 2. How many people are gonna cry at me if I do that intentionally? Probably a lot of people. Let's make it 3. I don't want people being like, nee, 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 nee. You were inaccurate, Haddock. Alright, do 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 do. Did I make enough room for the full sword? I did make enough room for the full sword, Spiffy. And that is the laziest sword I have ever drawn. Cool. But once I cover it in fire, you're not going to see the outline that much anyway, so I am fine with it. I'm liking your 2 comments, Wolfie saying Hiccup's too busy inventing and flying to change clothes, and then it's probably Berkian tradition to not wash her clothes. I could see both of those. Also, yeah, Hiccup is way too busy inventing and flying to change clothes. Yeah. Absolutely agree. Oops, don't like that. Fire! Alright, 1 second, I might start have to sing. This is my favorite part. Yay. Right here. That's my favorite part. Yay for Mozart. Okay, I'm happy now. And, Fury. Oh, we're starting to scream about the extreme things that Hiccup does. Yeah, no kidding. Okay, yeah, that still looks like Hiccup. I might have to make his eyes a little bit, more angular. And really emphasize those, yikes, way too much, eye bags. Yeah, that might cause some sweat. Yeah, a lot of sweat. Yeah, okay, also Hiccup's stupid clothing in the second movie. That stupid clothing in the second movie. As someone who made that stupid clothing for cosplay, I can tell you in excruciating detail about how fucking stupid and impractical Hiccup's clothes are. Also very sweat-inducing, yes. Yes. Give him old man Rufus's mustache. I love solid Rufus's mustache. Like, okay, Rufus is a badass looking adult. Like, the scar and the mustache and, oh my gosh, I'm sorry. Rufus, like, I don't know which design I like better because Rufus in his, like, what, you know, 50s, 60s or whatever, looks so good. Like, he should not have aged that well. Ugh! The unfairness of one cartoon character old men actually look extremely good. I did not give enough. Oof to that. This is gonna look better if I extend it. Make it a little bit wider. Actually, I haven't drawn Rufus in his older design. I've drawn a lot of goal, future goal from Deponia Doomsday because I love her short hair, and I'm actually much better at drawing goal when she has her short hair. So that's definitely on me, is drawing her hair short is my strength. That is really not that accurate, but again, I don't care. People are not going to be nitpicking this. I say now. Okay, and then you have to have some of the flaps that Hiccup has coming out. Okay, so he's holding his hand up, which means that it would be outside. So down here. Okay. That's where the flaps would be. Cool. Okay. Then a really bad elbow and pretend that the arm actually has some anatomy. Nope. We're just gonna completely fuck it over even worse than my original sketch. Cool. Nope, that's not acceptable. That does not look okay. Man, this symphony is so underrated. Okay. Nope, that's gonna make. Nah, limbs. Fuck limbs. Ugh, why can't we all be amoebas? Furious. Rufus with Inferno is the worst idea in history. Okay, but you know, if Rufus got to wear Hiccup's clothes, you know he would grab the frickin' Inferno. We just know he would. Okay, that's really faked, but you know what? We're going with that really faked proportion. Yeah, Rufus would immediately create absolute disaster with Inferno. There is no question about it. Little bit of palm there. No, yikes. Yeah, Astrid would be the person who would clean her clothes and be actually like neat and crap. She would. You are not wrong, Pickles. Oh, yeah, the Gronkle Iron Shield too. Yeah, just we don't want Rufus with anything. Like literally, you don't want Rufus with anything. And yet I gave him things, which is disastrous, but at the same time, you can't not disaster this situation up. If you're gonna draw Rufus in How to Train Your Dragon stuff, you gotta go the full mile, right? And then just prepare for the consequences. I could draw like a bonus sketch really quickly of him, like, everything on fire. Furious. Rufus is not allowed to be in position of literally any object. Where is the lie? Where is the lie? Okay. Oh, right, it's that stupid circle that's over there. I was like, what was my stupid sketch supposed to be? That, yeah, that's that circle windy thing that Hiccup has right there. Okay, cool. I remembered. Okay, Dr. Pickle says you mentioned a How to Train Your Dragon Gravity Falls crossover earlier on Tumblr, and I can't stop thinking about it. Oh my gosh, can we please talk about it? Because once I'm done with this, I am totally drawing that Gravity Falls How to Train Your Dragon crossover, and I would love to talk to people about it. I was thinking about it from the angle of what if all the Gravity Falls characters were in the How to Train Your Dragon universe? I hadn't thought about characters interacting or anything, but I was just thinking about, you know, what it would it be like if Dipper and Mabel and Stan were Vikings and there were dragons everywhere. And oh my gosh, Ford would be that person who's running around, you know, writing like basically some sort of ultra ridiculous dragon manual and stalking dragons and, you know, basically doing what Bork the Bold did. Oh no, it was, no shit. What was the name of that guy who did the dragon catalog. It was, yeah. Dr. Pictol, I just drew Mabel with a terrible terror because of that. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, I need to see that art! Is it on Tumblr? I need to see that. I need to reblog it 300 times and be so excited about that. If you put it online. Oh yeah, Bork the very, very unfortunate. Thank you, Wolfie. Yeah. So, Ford would be the person writing all the Dragon Manual stuff except in the present and as the adventurous Indiana Jones like idiot he is. Maybe. Something like that. He would be running off on adventurers. Yeah. Okay, then when he wrote the Book of Dragons, he became Bork the Bold. That's right! I was like, I know the Bork the Bold came in there somewhere, but I knew that his epithet, or whatever you call it, was originally not as flattering. Thank you, Wolfie! I don't watch Book of Dragons that much. I'm a little weak on the lore in that one. Sweet! Okay. Okay, my finger slipped. How bad? Okay, my finger didn't slip too bad. No one's gonna notice that. Cool. Oh, yay. Such a repetitive symphony, but it's so much fun. Wolfie, I've seen it way too often. Nice. Hey, it means you know your stuff, right? I think the fandom gets really confused at the fact that I don't tend to watch a lot of the materials a lot. So, like, most of Race to the Edge I've seen only once, and then people send me these really minute questions about what happened in this episode, in this minute, with this minor character interaction. I'm like, I did not remember this existed at all. I need to rewatch and rethink it. Pickle, you like the music? Yay! Glad you liked it. I was sitting there thinking, like, what sort of music do I feel like listening to, and which one would not get people yelling at me? Because I've been listening to a lot of 1940s bluegrass, but I figured, like, that would get some people complaining at me. So I went for, some nice common practice period music. If people complain to Mozart, they are sad, sad people. Just kidding. I love classical. Oh, Wolfie, I know that feel for Race to the Edge. I just know Book of Dragons and Gift of the Night Fury. Nice. Yeah, I know Gift of the Night Fury pretty well by now. For Race to the Edge, I know, like, the first two seasons really well, and then everything after that is sort of vagueness. Is sort of what ended up happening, because I watched the first two seasons of Race to Edge multiple times, and then, I ended up getting out of a dragon's phase and not really thinking about dragon's phase stuff as much. Okay, so, Dr. Pickle, oh, I'm seeing your comment earlier about the art. You didn't put it on Tumblr, but you can. Awesome! Yes! Yes, 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 I'm excited. Feel free to tag me in it if you would like, just because I want to make sure that I see it. I admit, I'm not 100% sure what your Tumblr URL is, my friend. But you don't have to, you know, share in public or whatever if you don't want. But anyway, I'm so excited you drew that. Ah! Yeah. I do not know canon as well as people think I do. Anyway. Okay. Has anyone talked about a Gravity Falls Undertale crossover? That's interesting! Okay, I've talked about Undertale crossovers with almost all of my fandoms, but actually not Gravity Falls. Oh my gosh, you're the vegetable which no one dares names! Oh yes, I love you! Okay, sorry, I love you. Yes, okay, I know who you are. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. Okay. Yeah, so, yeah, Undertale, Gravity Falls, you know, that actually works, Fury, because of all the monsters. Oh my gosh, like, okay, so my brain went to this concept of, you know, Undertale is one of the many dimensions that, you know, you can go to the portal in. So, you know, more monsters, you know, different dimension. That's the problem with Gravity Falls is... That's one of the- there's some fandoms I've noticed that it's really easy to cross over with versus others. How to Train Your Dragon is amazingly versatile when it comes to crossovering. Like, you can cross over stuff so easily. Yeah. Canon is overrated. I'm one of those people, I have a huge respect for canon, but at the same time, I love thinking outside of canon too. I'm definitely more stickler than lots of people I know. Especially when it comes to things like ships. I notice that my ships tend to, not always, but tend to be fairly rooted in what canon already gives me. But that's because I actually see the character dynamics and know they're not just like two random people shoved in the same room for the heck of it. But at the same time, it's like, you know, the wonderful world about fandom and its creativity is the fact that we can do whatever the hell we want with it. Okay, am I actually gonna do the small legs like I was doing with Rufus? Do I actually hate this completely? You know, we're sticking with it. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh! Yeah, Pickle, I love doing that too! I love doing that so much. That is so much fun. So, taking characters from different fandoms and signing them dragons. I love doing that. Like, I remember, I've done that for a lot of fandoms. Undertale, I gave people dragons one time. Gravity Falls, I haven't given people dragons yet. Speaking of that crossover, if we want to talk that crossover, you know, who would have what dragon is a very interesting thing to think about, for characters. Yeah. And Wolfie says, yeah, I need to see two characters interact a lot for me to be able to ship them. I don't understand how people can do that thing where a character appears for 2 seconds with half a line and they ship them with everyone. Yeah, I don't do that. I mean, part of it is that I am Arrow Ace, so romance isn't something that is a thing I innately care about to the same extent that lots of people do. So if you... You know, romance is the relationship that I tend to care about the least in fiction. So you have to be very compelling to me to give me a reason in canon for why I should care about a romance when fiction is saturated with crappy romances for me to like it. And if you just like, oh, these two random characters would be good romantically, I'd be like, but why not friends? Why not any other relationship? Why are you making them automatically romantic? And I cannot care. Yeah. Although Furious is pointing out what happened during one other, frickin' stream several years ago when I was playing Undertale. Storiel happened. That was fun, and I still like Storiel. Shipping Stoic with Toriel. It actually works! It does work. They have a lot in common. I can see the relationship developing. It's an interesting concept. But yeah, in general, my ships tend to be based upon relationships that are very secure in canon. And Dr. Pickle, yeah, true, that's mood, and yes to all that. Yay! High five. Okay, how are the legs looking? Leg-like. Yes, good. Legs look like legs. I fucking hate legs. Granted, I say that about, like, every single part of the human body when I'm drawing it. I'm like, I hate it. I hate it so badly. Why must it exist? Okay. Do that for the stupid frog legs wrapped in bacon thing. Okay, cool. Do the knobbly knee thing because I always draw big knobbly knees and big knobbly elbows and all that stuff. Wolfie, maybe that's why you like Hiccup one less like to draw. I mean, you're not wrong. And high five with Pickle hating the human body while drawing is such a mood. Like, dude, human bodies are so cool looking, but the more I try to draw them, the more I'm like, why? Why? Yeah, the legs right here are very stylized, and they might be complete crap, or they might look okay. Who knows? I'm saying too late to change now and sticking with them. I'm having I'm also going through some periods of trying to redefine style, so I'm experimenting right now, so this is necessary experimentation. Oh, for the fuck of fuck, I drew it on the wrong layer again. Why am I this absolutely idiotic? Oh, also I haven't saved in a while. Save. Okay. There we go. Yeah, like, I would start complaining about which parts of the body are the most painful to draw, but let's be real, all of them. Pickle says, I basically only draw humans because they're fun, but also, ugh! Yeah, same, 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 and same. Although, when I was a kid, I drew a lot of animals. And so, for me, I got really good at drawing animals and realistic animals, and I also did more photorealistic, just copy it straight from a photograph sort of drawing. So I didn't get used to drawing proportions outside of what I directly saw. So I know, theoretically, what human proportions are, but it's hard for me to draw them in sort of a stylized, cartoony way. So for me, this is a whole new world of trying to draw in a very, 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 very different way. And it's fun, but it means I feel like I'm completely behind the crowd in everything. But you know what? That's life, right? You know, you keep on learning and growing, and it's gonna be pretty exciting once I start being less like crap. Fury. Yeah, you're constantly drawing Night Furies and Toothless. Constantly. But to be fair, all of your practice has paid off heavily, and every single time I see your dragons, I'm just so impressed with how you can draw dragons. That is something I cannot draw. I cannot do dragons. I can draw musical instruments. That should be a surprise to nobody. Cats. I'm very good at cats. Yep, practice makes perfection, says Fury. And that's a mood. High five. We're all sharing the mood, yo. Okay, there we go. I am actually getting faster at this. I know I'm so slow, but again, I am getting faster. I am starting to finally understand what the fucking hell digital art is. And I actually also own a tablet that isn't completely for beginners, so yay. So Pickle asks, does anyone else here forget to draw wings on dragons? Like, you'd think it would be easy to remember. Okay, so I admit when I draw dragons, I'm, like, only thinking about the wings. Like, that is the only thing I am frickin' thinking about. The wings look amazing and everything looks terrible. So I'm more likely to forget basic things like, oh yeah, they might need, you know, hips on their back legs and stuff. So, yeah. Not drawing now, but enjoying it. Yay, thanks. Alright, so let's... Hey! Hey! That actually looks not complete shit! Woo! Oh, ba-dum-tsh. You just have to wing it, says Bobby. Alright, awesome. Is this the final movement? Which movement is this? Yes, it is the final movement, and then... Okay, I'm starting to feel more Beethoven now. Or Dvorak, my baby Dvorak. That one, if I remember correctly, they start with... There we go. I want to play that. That's good, because he's supposed to be Rufus, Jaya, so I'm glad I'm starting to get a little bit more Rufus-y in that. The darn thing is those two actually look really similar, except for some basic facial proportions, such as, like, the cheekbones. Rufus has very interesting cheekbones. And then, like, the facial hair, obviously. I'm glad that the, I'm glad you like the pose, because, oh my gosh, the pose was so bloody hard. I'm bad at poses. I'm so bad at poses. So it's something that I've been consciously trying to work on and get better at. So I'm glad that it paid off. Thank you so much. Yep. I'm basically going through the suggestions that people made on Tumblr at that one post. Somewhere. How long ago was it? Pulling up with the different. I'm trying to remember what all the different suggestions and requests were. It was like, what, 5 days ago? How the fuck did that get that many notes? Looking. Scrolling. Where the fuck is that thingy? Keep on scrolling. Ride. What does Hiccup look like in the Rufus jacket, says Fury? That is an important question. That is a good point. Okay, it was further back than this. Yeah, wow, this was a while ago. Okay, I was also blogging a lot. Now I want to draw. Oh, here it is. Okay. So Peach was the one who said Rufus dressed as Hiccup. Right, okay. And then Jaya said Pidge in Dipper's lamb costume. And then I'm definitely doing Pidge meets Mabel and Dipper. I haven't decided what Dipper's doing, but Mabel is gonna have Pidge's shit, how did I forget the name of that? Pidge's weapon. How did I forget the name of that all of a sudden? So I'm gonna be drawing, Mabel shooting that out and being way too excited and Pidge running and being like, no! Which is probably poses way beyond my ability, but I'm gonna try anyway. And then I was talking to Ashley and, about the Gravity Falls stuff crossover. Okay. Anyway, don't get distracted, fish. Yeah. And yeah, I do have commissions, and I am still behind on them. I feel terrible about that. But to be fair, I can't finish my one music piece until my tambourine comes in the mail, and it comes in on Monday. So, yeah. Yeah, Bayard! Thank you! Yes! Mabel with the Bayard is what's gonna happen, and it's gonna be a wonderful disaster, and she's gonna be just as excited as when she has the grappling hook. Because let's be real, they're pretty similar. Yes. And Dipper, I don't know what Dipper's doing. I don't know what Dipper is doing. I feel like I had an idea for Dipper and then forgot it. Pickle, that's a great idea. Thanks. Yay. Oh no, the circle is not circly enough. As everybody jokes in Fullmetal Alchemist, the real amazing thing about all the alchemists is that they can draw in fucking perfect circles. You know what? Fucking close enough. Again, this is not supposed to be the best thing in the world. Yikes, that is a bad circle. Oh well. We're getting away with it, y'alls. We're getting away with it. Close enough. Yikes! Idiot. Okay, Jaya. If you do Viggo and Ryko versus Dipper and Mabel, I'll pay you. Just let me know your rates. I've never done an art commission, so I honestly have no idea how much to ask for. But that would be fun. That would be very hard, and it might be slightly pushing my skill level, but that could be interesting. Yeah, we can talk about that. After I finish my music composition. So yeah. Furious draw a hidden transmutation circle in one of the layers. Okay, oops. You know, the last thing we want is Rufus next to a transmutation circle, though. Last thing we want. Okay, and thanks, Dr. Pickle, that's a pretty dang good circle. And yes, Jaya, that would be enough. Yeah. Do you have any ideas about what their poses and, what the face-off would be, or do you want me to just go wild with it? Coward? I'm a coward? Rufus using alchemy would be the destruction of our universe. It is, indeed. We have found something more terrifying than Rufus using Inferno. Yikes. And thanks. I'm glad these circles are close enough. Once I do shading, no one will notice, I say. Alright, so confrontational. Alright. basically the brothers towering over them. Oh, I see. Okay. Dramaticness. But the twins not backing down. Yeah, they wouldn't back down. That would be fun. Rufus doing... Oh my gosh. See, Rufus would be this person who'd be like, blah, 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 blah. Human transmutation, who cares? Do-do-do-do-do. Yikes. Would it... Okay, so here's the thing. With Full Metal Alchemist and what you lose is it's all based upon what your biggest... your biggest weaknesses. It's all about your sin. So what Rufus loses is in accordance to his sin. And since Rufus is a thief, I would say he loses both of his hands. Anyone gonna, you know, debate me on that one? Come up with an alternate idea? That's my vote. Unless, yeah, so that's my instinct, is Rufus loses both of his hands if he did the alchemy taboo. Hurt my throat. Yikes. Feels. How dare you? Get away from me now and never come back. Yeah. I feel like one hand wouldn't be enough. I mean, then he could just steal with the other hand, right? I feel like it'd have to be both hands. Sort of like what happened with Stan when he took the watch. Fury, yes, you killed the fish. But to be fair, the Deponia games killed me first. What would Goal lose her brain again? Alright, so let's see. What is Goal's... So let's see. Assuming that... So again, it's based on sin. As you said, yeah, truth doesn't work like that. So Goal's folly is that she doesn't... let the past be. She refuses to let the past be. She refuses to let what is inevitable be inevitable. How does that relate to body parts? Man, I'd have to think on her. And man, I have so many feels when I listen to this particular symphony by Dvorak. I know people always talk about New World, which is number 9, but for me, 8 is the one that I get the most emotions over because I've performed 8 two times, one time on the flute and one time on the viola, which was pretty awesome. So I got to be really intimately familiar with all of the parts in the music and listen to it from different perspectives. Because you really think about the song differently when you're playing the viola as versus the flute. And when I was doing in the flute, it was during my senior year of high school, during All-State Orchestra. I somehow, there was like a fluke or something, I somehow got first chair flute in All-State Orchestra my senior year in the top orchestra, which means that I had to play all of the solos. And, man, that was the experience of a lifetime. Like, I cannot tell you how invigorating the orchestra was with even the first tuning note. And sometimes when I listen to this song, I can still feel the orchestra for what it was when I sat down there. Because what's so cool about being flute is you're in the fucking center. You are in the center. And so you get perfect sound balance. And it's just the power. Oh my gosh, it was so amazing. Thanks, Jaya. Yeah, it was definitely my biggest achievement as a flute player. Maybe even as a musician, honestly. Yeah, I would say even as a musician, that was my biggest experience. And so it's something that I hold dear with me. And so this song I almost tattooed this on my back. I ended up going with another song that I have good memories of. But if I got another music tattoo, I might do something from Dvorak's Eighth, just because it has still stuck with me all these years later. You should be proud, Fury. Proud of the horrified screeching that you made me suffer through and do. And BT Dubs, don't look too closely at this shield. The design does not have as many Fury wing nubby flap things as is actually on the shield, but I do not want to draw all of those, so we're faking it. And I still know, like, every single fucking note to this song. I still have the main solo in the fourth movement memorized. Like, yeah, this song is gonna always stick with me. So maybe I'll tattoo some of it. Probably the opening to this movement, the da 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 da. That would be cool. And it would not look bad, musically, design-wise. I'd have to think about it. I could also do the very start of the fourth movement. Yeah, I don't know. Too many tattoo ideas, not enough canvas space. This is the thing that I hate about having a smaller physical body, is there's not enough room for me to get all the tattoos that I want on my body. I've run out of room. I'll run out of room. Okay. I think. Yes! Hallelujah! Oh man, that shield is so fucked up. Whatever. We're gonna call this... good. We're gonna call this the lines, and we're gonna start the coloring process. New paint layer. Okay, and this was the usual basic 5-3 pixels, basic dash 5 shape. I always write down what I do right here so I don't forget it in case I have to go back to it. Cool. Background, and I know you're not supposed to do white. Wolfie, I hadn't even thought about naming this. Literally, just what I have on the top right here is I just have it titled as Rufus as Hiccup. But Seconds to Disaster is literally the funniest thing I have ever seen, and I'm laughing my ass off at that. That's amazing. And you are so not wrong. Alright, so let's just see. Da-da! Boom! Yeah, I love this. Okay, let's see. Thinky. I'm gonna pull up. I'm gonna cheat, for once. Don't blame me for cheating. Oh, updating Steam, of course. Boo! Alright, we'll just make a background color that's filler for now. Oh, Dvorak, I love you so much. Okay, there we go. Steam news, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so, but da-da-da-da, Deponia, this art pamphlet, was it from... was it Goodbye? Local files, browse local files, premium content, animator's workbook, here it is. Because they give us everything we need. Yeah, that's a lot of Star Wars in my Steam library. It came in a bundle pack. Really, really, really cheap. Okay. So, they even do a step-by-step on how they color Rufus, which is ridiculous. But honestly, that's not the worst plan. Okay. And then they actually see, they give the color IDs. Isn't that so cool? Okay, you know, I actually might do that. Just so that I can get a bottom layer in. Okay. That color, hide that layer, image, new paint layer. Cool. Okay. Just do a quick layer. Save me the trouble of having to fill in the lines perfectly in the future. Okay, we're actually gonna pause the music. Because I want to do a quick restroom break, so I will BRB in a moment. Alright, I'm back. Spiffy. Alright, on to movement 2. Cool. Maybe a tiny bit more zoom just to make sure I don't do anything stupid. Because who always does stupid things? Raise his hand. Oh my gosh, I keep on getting sidetracked. We never did talk about who would be what dragon for Gravity Falls, How to Train Your Dragon crossover. So let's see. Thinking through the different dragon species. Furious Night Fury says raise his hand and Rufus also. Yeah, so I'm curious, yeah, why the raise hand? What's interesting? Part of me is wondering if like I'm trying to think about like what Grunkle Stan would do, you know, if we want to do the more gruff dragon, you know, sort of like a Grunkle. Did I say Grunkle instead of Gronkle? Oh my gosh. The Grunkle's Gronkle. You almost have, but it's too affectionate for him. Hot Burble? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Pickle says, I want Stan to have a terror just to get on his nerves. That would be hilarious. I feel like somebody else would have the terror but would live with him, and so he has to suffer with the terror and he hates it. Wait. Okay, so we could think about... So Mabel's dragon would basically be her equivalent of Waddles, wouldn't it? Or would she have Waddles plus a dragon? Because that might change what sort of species I give her. Rumble Horn Furious suggests for Stan. That's an interesting idea. Nothing's really, really singing to me yet. Yeah. Wolfie Mabel would have a Gronkle. That could work. I feel like Gronkles are a bit more dog-like, and she's a cat person, but the Gronkle's affection and the cuteness factor and so forth, she would definitely be happy with a Gronkle. Timberjack for 1D. Oh, that's perfect! Oh my gosh, yes! Yes! Timberjack for 1D. I'm never gonna dispute that. That's perfect. Gronkles can carry sheep in their mouths. Imagine one doing it with Waddles. Oh my gosh. Just Mabel flying around on a Gronkle with a pig in its mouth. That'd be amazing. Yeah, oh my gosh, the Timberjack for 1D is so perfect. Man, now I feel like I need to pull up a list of dragons just to start looking and thinking through who would be what. Who would be easier to figure out than others? My brain's going Pacifica and Natter, but I don't know if I'm 100% sold on it, but it's not bad. Grenda seems like a person who could have a Grunkle. Man, why are these people so hard? Like, I'm trying to think of like what would work with like the main cast, like Dipper and Stan and Ford and stuff. Like, usually some people are pretty easy. Like, you know, damn. Okay, thinking through. You know, I might just have to start listing personality traits and stuff until a dragon pops into my head about what would make sense. But now I am intrigued, and now I have to think about this ad infinitum until, like, something really is there. So Furious says it's tempting to put a Zipple back for either pairs of twins. That's true. I feel like a Zipple back for Dipper and Mabel would make a lot more sense if we did a Zipple back for anybody. Yeah, I'm definitely with you, Wolfie, for a Natter with Pacifica. That's where I'm leaning with. Oh my gosh, Furious, stand with the smoke breaths. Oh my gosh. Oh, that would be such a disaster. Oh my gosh, I love it so much. Fury, yes. And listen to the music, it's gonna climax right now in triumph. There you go. See, the music climaxes and hits its triumphant point because you are right. Oh my gosh. Yes, the smoke breath would fucking steal stuff for Stan. It's so perfect. It's so perfect. It's so bad and it's so perfect. Yep, okay. Yep. You win. Yep, that's it. All right. So, yeah. So Timberjack, Wendy, smoke breath, Stan, Natter, Pacifica. I'm chilling with all of these. The smoke that he can hide in. Yeah, Stan, you know, instead of the smoke bomb, just, you know, running into the smoke from the dragons. Oh gosh, yeah, that's a beautiful one. Yeah, the smoke breath nest, like Stan would train them to like pick up gold and silver and no other metals. And so there'd be literally this like dragon-like pile of gold in Stan's house, and Stan's constantly fighting with the smoke breath for who gets to grab the gold. Oh my gosh. And every once in a while the smoke breaths like steal his, you know, gold chains. All right, so get that bad omen dragon from Hidden World. Oh, the footballs. Oh my, Mabel would love those. Mabel would love those, guys, let's be real. But I don't know if that would be her or someone like Seuss. The footballs. What are they called? Yeah. Hobgobblers, yeah. Oh my gosh, what would Seuss have? Seuss would either have like a hobgobbler or a hot purple or oh gosh. Robbie would want to have a monstrous nightmare. He would think he'd be cool enough for a monstrous nightmare, but I doubt he would actually have a monstrous nightmare. You know, one of those things that Robbie brags about but, you know, can't fill up fulfill. Yeah, Seuss could definitely be a Gronkle person. Yeah, I could get behind that one. I'm thinking through. Oh man, there's so many characters too, because it's like, you know, we could talk about like who Manly Dan has or who Blubs and Derlin have. Oh my gosh. The dragons that Blubs and Derlin have. Oh dear. What would they have? So, okay, so Pickle says for Ford, maybe something exotic-y like a Death Song, Razor Whip, Night Fury, or a Changewing. Yeah, like, I was sort of thinking about it too, because the obvious quote-unquote go-to would be the Night Fury, because Ford has disappeared, the Night Fury's disappeared, but I feel like that's too much of a stereotypical go-to that I don't like the idea. I also don't like the idea of giving characters Night Furies, because, as we know, they're basically extinct. But yeah, it would definitely make sense for Ford to have something that's more exotic-y. You know, my brain had started going down Whispering Death, but that didn't seem right. Changewing. Changewing is sort of interesting. Changewings are feisty. Man, what would... Razor Whip's interesting. Maybe Mabel would like a Changewing with all the colors it can be. She could. Mabel with just, like, all the dragons. You could literally assign her anything and it would work. Man, okay, yeah, because I agree with you, Pickles, that Ford has something a little bit more on the exotic and also sort of on the edgier side, if that makes sense. It's something dramatic, because he's a stupid dramatic little butt. Man, yeah, now I need to, like, pull up a freaking list. I was also thinking, like, what would Manly Dan be? Would it be something like a Thunderdrum or a Monstrous Nightmare or a, Rumblehorn? Death songs are pretty dramatic. They really are, and I love death songs. They're one of my favorites. Singed Tail. Yeah, what's the manliest dragon? That's the question we have to ask. In the first movie, it was the Monstrous Nightmare, but I feel like we've gotten to know more dragons since then. So something like the Rumblehorn could be considered more manly. Like, you know, big, thick, dramatic. It's like a bull, except it's a dragon. A bull beetle dragon. But are there any manlier dragons out there? Stormcutter! Dude, Stormcutter for Ford would actually be really cool. I could get behind that really well. Also reminds me of the analysis that someone prompted me for earlier comparing Stoic and Stan, and I sort of gave the comment about Valka and Ford having parallel roles. So Ford on a Stormcutter, you know, I like that. Yes, oh, we've got agreement there on Pickles as well. All right. Yeah, oh my gosh, yeah, I love the idea of Ford on this, like, giant fucking Stormcutter. Yeah, it's extra enough for the guy. Yep, I like it. Oh gosh, I'm so happy with this. I'm so happy. Yeah, maneuverable and dramatic. Yeah, exactly. And it can, you know, he can charge off on adventures with the Stormcutter. And they both look like owls. Oh my gosh, you're not wrong. Ford does sort of look like his dragon, doesn't he? That's funny. Okay, if anybody has a Zippleback they share, I'm imagining, like, Nate and Lee, because they're always together. You know, the other, manly dragon that we could talk about is that giant, big moose boy. But I think that is even too much for Manly Dan. That would be like what the Manitars ride. Wow, now my brain's like going into this stupid AU where like Ford is like hiding, like, you know, Valka did, and it's like, you know, in that dragon sanctuary, and like, hey, look, I found an alpha! Okay, that's weird. Wow. Okay. Maybe those big shouty water dragons. Thunder drums! I love thunder drums. They're such beautiful babies. I love thunder drums so much. And then Titan Nightmare for Dan. Oh man. There's options. There's definitely options. Like, thunder drum isn't bad either. None of them are like really, really singing to me yet. All right. And how the fuck does Dipper not have a dragon yet? Or okay, Dipper and Mabel, we're having difficulties with. I can't believe how difficult the main cast is. Like, I was thinking about how easy it was to assign dragons when I was doing the Undertale one, and you know, Sans, I took one glance at it and I was like hot purple and I went on with my life. Like, it did not take time at all to think about. Man, okay, Dipper. Why is Dipper hard? I really am tempted to just pull up the fucking How to Train Your Dragon wiki right now and just look at the list. Okay. Save. Ooh, a Skrill. Fuck, I hadn't even thought about a Skrill. Oh my gosh, a Skrill. Who would have a Skrill? That's another dragon that Robbie would want but doesn't own. Okay. Remembering this wiki, where's the tag for dragons? Maybe looking up dragons. Okay, here we're just gonna do it this way. Alright, so when you say smart and curious, my mind immediately goes to Natter, but I don't know. Yeah, Natter is not a bad fit for Dipper. I don't feel like it's the best fit, but it's not a bad fit. And yeah, there's no nerd dragon species. That's sort of funny. Okay, let's see where the tag things are. Category, there's the category that I was looking for. Okay, here we are. Okay. So we've got like Armor Wing. Buffalord, eh. So many fucking dragons. Gideon seems like a changeling guy. That's an interesting idea. There's a comedic value in Gideon on a Quaken. Yeah, that there is something entertaining about that. Got Bone Napper. Man, there's just so many fucking dragons. Who'd get a bone napper? Well, that's a gothy dragon for you. Could maybe say Robbie, I don't know. I don't feel like I've cracked him yet either. Changewing. Yeah, I really do feel like someone should have a changewing, but I'm not sold on who yet. swear there's a page where it just lists off the main dragon species, but whatever. Death Song, Death Gripper. No one has a Death Gripper. Although I did see the question earlier, what does Bill have? Which is a really interesting question. Maybe Dan would have the Quaken. That would not be bad. Desert Wraith. Doomfang. I love Doomfangs. Okay, the problem is this is all pulled in together with all the everythings. I still have this memorized because I had to practice this so fucking hard. I'll think about this more later. Why is this so hard? The Gronsicle. Ground Splitters. I love Typhoomerangs, too. I don't feel like anyone would have them. Ugh, so many fucking species. Oh, it's such an interesting concept. Crossovers are just so much fun. I enjoy crossoveringness because the fun thing about crossovers is similar to what Wolfie was saying near the beginning of the stream of, you know, canon's overrated. The fun thing about crossovers is it completely frees you from any canon constraints. Is, you don't have to really think anything about canon because as soon as you put a crossover in the mix, you're putting two different worlds together, sometimes two different character sets together, two different circumstances. You have so much free rein for about how it goes down, and you can do as much canon compliance or non-compliance as you want without anybody blinking an eye. And I love that so much. So crossovers are just a really good sense of unending creative freedom for me. And I know that you can be as, you know, canon non-compliant in any sort of AU or fic as you want, but I feel like crossovers, especially the very nature of a crossover, provides that natural freedom. And Wolfie's saying, yes, I'm having so much damn fun with my Hogwarts story right now because I can just put in so many characters I'd never write on their own. That's true, yeah. I sort of had that fun when I was doing my superhero AU. Is I had so much fun just sneaking in little Easter egg appearances of any character and basically trying to put in everybody, whether they had a big role or not, and it just... unending freedom. So much fun. Hogwarts AUs are good stuff, too. Those are always fun to talk about. Who's what house. Another, you know, discussion that you gotta do with fandom is, you know, who's what house. And I say that as someone who's never even read the Harry Potter books. I know enough about the houses to do house discussions, too, which is really sad. Okay, cool. My laptop's starting to complain at me. Too bad, buddy. Crossovers are so much fun. I know some people don't get as into them as other things. Crossovers for me are just, let's have so much fun. I have just saved now, thanks Wolfie. Good catch. There's never such thing as saving too many times. It's like one of the types of corns that we grow in our garden, early and often. That's how you should save. Dr. Pickle, I'm trying to get my sister's opinion on Dip and Mabel's dragons. Nice. I might pester some of my IRL friends, too. Just for the funsies of it. Granted, I think most of my IRL friends are at a Comic-Con this weekend, so I'm not gonna hear nothing from any of them right now. They're all gonna be screaming about their cosplays and shit, so... yeah, I hope they have fun. I am taking a relaxing weekend, thank you very much. She's kind of stumped too. Wow. That's really interesting. That is so fascinating. When I might pull up School of Dragons, because the set of dragons that they list is a little bit more manageable to look at, and then just think through a bit more and maybe toss some ideas back and forth at you, send you an ask or something, and we can bait it out again. You're going to a local con? That's awesome, Fury. Nice. This weekend, one of the biggest anime cons is going on in Denver, so that's where all my friends are at. Well, biggest local-ish, you know, state things. Dipper needs a book dragon. Oh, that's a good point. Yeah, book dragon. What's a good book dragon, though? Okay. How much are we gonna cheat? We gonna cheat. So, save. I love Windwalkers. Book dragon. Oh, needs- yeah, dragon for the book. Okay, yeah, you're going to the bed now because you're super tired. That's true. Time zone's probably pretty late for you, man. Dude, it was good hanging out with you. That was a lot of fun. I'll catch up with you more later. Oh my gosh, did she really? Yeah, thanks! Yeah, I'll have fun! I... keep on doing that. That's on monitor. Okay, so they do that for the line. This last page is so much bloody fun to play. Okay, so they do actually have a more black line than what we have there. Do I want to go with the line that much darker? You know, we might. Group, quick group. Do this, lazy cheat. And I'm gonna take a quick break from music just cause it's hard for me to always music it up. There's the cheat trick. Cool. Yeah, just the slightest bit darker, that does help. Cool. Save, layer, new paint layer, gonna do a 5 and maybe give a few extra emphases on places just to clean it up. Yikes, looks terrible. Now I'm at the coloring stage, woot woot! Exciting, I might actually finish something for once in my fucking life. Eh, we're not gonna do that right now. Flare. Okay. So. cheating time continues, but I'm not very good with coloring yet, so we're gonna do that. Layer, new paint layer. Spiffy. And quick face. Does he really have that color of a face? Huh. Is that really what it is? Well, how about that? That is a lot peachier than I usually draw skin tones, which is why I'm sort of fascinated. Oosh. Yeah, my laptop is really angry at me. It's still yelling. Can you guys hear it? Probably through the mic, I'm imagining. And ears. I love drawing ears. One of the best things ever. Fingers. Fingery, fingery, fingers. Yep, the laptop is very angry at me. It's doing a lot of hard work for a long period of time. I might actually have to end up giving it a bit of a break. Finish up at a later time, depending on how angry the laptop stays at me. Yeah, it's angry. It'll be fine, but I'm pushing it, that's for sure. I think that's all I have for skin tones. Yep. Skin tone. I feel bad cheating. I usually don't cheat at all, even. I usually always try to pick my color palette, so I feel so bad doing this. But I'm trying to learn from the experience of doing this, and we'll see how it ends up turning out. Poor grumpy laptop. You know you love me, laptop! You know you love me. Although laptop is like one of my favorite insults to use at people. Because, you know, computers are obnoxious butts, so it just seems so appropriate to roll your eyes at someone and say, "You laptop!" Like, don't tell me, that sounds like an actual insult. That does. I totally vote that laptop is an insult. Oops. Pickles, I gotta add that to my insulted vocabulary. Do it, make it become a thing. Have everybody calling people laptops at each other. It will be worth it. Language. Revolution. Okay. Main hair. Insert layer, new paint layer. Fluff additions. Fury, you're gonna call your brother a laptop? Yes! It's basically a law. Beautiful. Is your brother rather much of a laptop? We're making the hair slightly spikier and fluffier by going outside of the lines. Because again, hair is my favorite thing ever, and you gotta make the hair fun. It's just life requirement. Then give him. Man, I messed up on that so bad. Whatever. There. I also tend to draw Rufus with sideburns. Good enough. Remove layer. And see if I can get away with doing this basic trick for shading. Go. Is that livable? That's livable. Amazing? No. But livable. Hey, I never promised that any of this would be good. Sort of want to do. Let's see if that works. I have an idea. Yep. That's not the worst idea that I've come up with. Color palettes. Choices on color palettes. Until I find something I like. Yeah, I can live with that. I should really be thinking color theorying it up, but I do not feel like that right now. Okay, his eyes are gonna drive me batshit until I actually color those in. All right, you guys, you know what? You know, I'm starting to get a little fatigued. It's not that I haven't made great progress and stuff, and it's not that I am not close or anything, but my laptop's screeching at me, and also I'm sort of getting hungry and stuff, so I might want to actually like go get food and stuff. So I might call this a night and finish this up later and post it and whatever other things I end up doing on Tumblr. Ah, the eyes are so creepy like that. We're layer new paint layer. Just get something in the eyes. Something so that it does not look bad. Start to look not terrible. Oh man. And then we'll fix the eyes more later. But at least it's an eye now. Yeah, I'm gonna call it a night. So, I'll probably actually be drawing again later tonight in my life because I sort of decided to take this day completely off, but I'm gonna give my laptop a break and I'm guessing I probably won't be streaming again. But dudes, it was so much fun to stream with you guys. Thanks for joining with me and hanging out. So, have a great evening. And yeah, Pickle, it was indeed fun chatting. I'll see you guys around. And yeah, I'll check out to see if you did post that Mabel up there and stuff. You guys have a wonderful one. I'm repeating myself now. Blah, 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 blah. Anyway, bye.